Now he's standing there looking around after what was, frankly, a pretty undignified approach to St. John's Episcopal Church. Looking, he's holding up a Bible, walking by some graffiti saying, "No justice, no peace," and FTP, which people can figure out what that stands for. Holding up a Bible.
"We have a great country. That's my thoughts. This country in the world. Great. We will make it even. And it won't take long. It's not going to take long. You see what's going on. It's coming back. It's coming back strong. It'll be greater than ever before."
"Do you rather want to further inflame tensions by using the U.S. military, Mr. President?"
Shouted out questions to the president as he is there across the street, as we said, with his staff, massive security detail, holding up a Bible. I'm just listening here along with everyone else, just to pause here for a moment, of the president setting up this photo op for himself, dispersing peaceful protesters to do so in front of a boarded up church, which had that fire due to the protests last evening. You can see him standing there. I think it's important just to talk about the image. He sees this as his big photo. You saw him sort of, you know, caring about the moment and the photo, now bringing everybody in here for his photo op. That's what this is all about for him. It's Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany. As he does this, and I will, Bill Barr, the Attorney General, who we saw coming in, we're going to continue to monitor this and listen. You know, Don, to the point that the governor was making, the president wanted this photo op and he wanted to disperse that crowd because he is, you know, he wants an image of this, all of these protests being one thing, which is violent, which, of course, is not accurate.
Yes. And listen, we work in television. We know when someone is producing a moment. And we know this president comes from a reality show background. And the fact that he says that he is going to protect protesters, peaceful protesters, and then sends in military or police officers to push them away when they're being peaceful is just, it's just really outrageous. And Aaron, we're New Yorkers. Donald Trump standing in front of a church with a Bible? Really? Let's just be honest here. When was the last time Donald Trump saw a church, even before he was president of the United States? When was the last time he cracked open a Bible? I'm just saying, this is all for show. Donald Trump is pretending in this moment to be a president. Let's just all be real about this. He's pretending to be a president. He is mimicking the person that he adores, his hero, George Patton, and he wants to return to some sort of 1950s sort of dominance for America. That's what he's doing. This is all acting. It's all a show. And he is performing in this country what he thinks a leader should be like and what he thinks a president of the United States should be like. But guess what? This is a very, very dangerous game. He is possibly igniting tensions. Not possibly. He is igniting tensions. I know more. I hope this doesn't turn out to backfire on him, because if it does, it's not going to play out well for many people in the United States beyond the president of the United States. But if it does, we will watch those images play out on our television screens, and America will see this. This is all about getting reelected in November of 2020. I'm not sure how much this is going to help the president. This may rah-rah help his base, but sensible Americans will realize, and they know, America is not a dictatorship. America is not a police state. When people are crying out to be heard, when they are protesting on the street, that means they are angry, they are hurt, and they want to be heard. We have the strongest, biggest military force in the world. We have very strong, very big police forces all over cities and municipalities in this country. We can stop rioters anytime we want. We can stop looters anytime we want. We can stop people who are breaking laws anytime we want. But what we can't figure out is how to deal with people who are hurting, Americans who are just like us, who live in the same communities, if not adjacent communities, who share the same land and the same values. We cannot figure out how to get along with them, bring them into the fold, and as the president of the United States, represent those people and engage those people without sicking military, the military on them, and armed forces on them. There is a problem and a lack of understanding and empathy coming from the highest office of the land. And the person who holds that office is Donald J. Trump.